Yo, yo, yo. This is Living for a Living. I'm Joey Bradley, and we are on episode 71.
Living for a living, baby. How you doing?
You like that little switch up for the intro? No welcome. Just this is. We are living for a living. Why? Yeah. Let's just get into it. I was doing some lives before this talking, and it's funny, funny is probably the right word to use. My TikTok live fan base makes me feel cute and attractive because majority of the people who are regulars in the lives are probably 25 to 35-year-old women who I think have to think I'm cute or charming or a little bit of both, you know what I'm saying? And I guess I've always thought I was cute, like dating back to middle school even. But I never felt that other people felt that or thought that. You know, I've had girlfriends and I've, you know, been with girls throughout the years or whatever, but I've just never felt attractive in that way. And maybe I think I have to be someone's kind of specific cup of tea, maybe. And so in real life, that might be harder to find someone who likes that specific cup or flavor. But online, it's much easier to find. And so, yeah, I don't know. It's all like, which it's completely opposite because, again, I went out this past weekend and normally anyone who recognizes me in person and will say something about TikTok in person, it happened multiple times this weekend again, is normally like 20-year-old to 22-year-old boys. And they're the ones who say anything in person. But then on the lives, it's all, like I said, 25 to 35-year-old women. And then there's like a couple dudes who hang out in the lives that seem pretty cool. And they're also smart. It's a good spot to hang out. So ladies, if you see me in person and you want to say something, that's okay too. I'm okay with that. Although actually there was a girl who did recognize me this weekend. And she was a girl who had like responded to the pronoun video that I did. And I actually did watch it. I told her at the time that I didn't even know what one she was, because at the time I didn't. I was a little drunk. Also, I didn't watch very many of the response videos that people would make, because what's the point? But she was super sweet and friendly and a little drunk herself. And it made me realize that most people who do stuff online or comment negative stuff online, when they see you in person, either one would never say anything like that in a mean way ever, and two, are kind of full of shit in a way, I guess. I mean, not full, I don't know what the right way to say it is. They're a different person online than they are in person. And I guess in a way, I am too. I don't know. Actually, I don't think I am. Sometimes I think I come off as an asshole on the internet. But that's because a lot of the times when people post stuff, like actual posts, not comments, people always want to give off this like, perfect, I'm the best, I'm the nicest, there's nothing wrong with me persona. And I have no problem not giving that off. But I have no problem being that exact same way in person. I try and be nice to everybody, like I've said, that I come in contact with throughout the day. But if I got to let a motherfucker know in person, I'm going to let a motherfucker know. Like yesterday at the lunch spot, I was waiting in line at the lunch place, and the delivery driver guy came in, and maybe I was in the wrong here, but he just, I'd been waiting in line for 5-10 minutes or whatever, and he just like went to the front and did it in kind of just an assholey way. If he would have just said something to me and been like, hey man, I'm here to pick it, you know, it wasn't like it was ready at the exact moment. And all I had to do was get my fork and knife so I could go sit down, you know? And I was like, hey man, I'm in line here. He's like, oh yeah. I was like, yeah, but I'm still in line. You know, like he could have, I don't know. There was just a way I probably would have let it slide. And he just didn't allow that to happen. And so I had to flex on him, motherfucker, one time. And I'll admit that kind of felt good. It's kind of fun to flex on somebody every now and then. Not in an unnecessary way, but just feels good every now and then. No? But no, I met this girl and she's more TikTok famous than me. But I didn't know, like I said, at the time, I watched the video, I even responded on the video, but I didn't know who she was, I didn't know anything. And we ended up talking and have a nice little conversation, kind of about the pronoun stuff, but just about whatever, we were both drunk. And she was super sweet and nice and friendly. And I kind of explained my exact point of view, which she ultimately somewhat agreed with. You know, I said, maybe I could have used a little bit different word, saying people are fucking idiots probably never works too well. And I understand that. That was kind of part of the bit. And she was like, well, could I like record you say what you just said? So that way I'm in this Facebook group or WhatsApp group of people, and that way they could understand what you actually meant, like I do now. And I was like, no, I just don't care that much, you know? And those people, a majority of them aren't going to change their mind regardless about me. So what's the point? But it was nice. And then we became friends on TikTok, and we might do a little collab at some point, because I think it'd be good for people to see, especially on an issue like that, but on any issue in general, someone who is more on one side of the fence. You know, she's probably, not probably, she is in the pronouns in the bio camp. She's got she, her in the bio. I'm on the other side, calling that side idiots. And so it'd be good for anyone to see that, okay, those two sides can then sit down, talk, have a nice time, dismiss the fact that there's maybe this one issue that we don't even really disagree on, but just the solution for it we disagree on. And can have a fun time regardless, you know, whether that be any issue right now, whether it be, I mean, the hot topic right now, which I'm not going to get into because I don't know enough about it, is Palestine, Israel, whether it's police, black person, whether it's black person, white person. I mean, I'm just thinking of all the ones that the media loves to separate us with. Republican Democrat might be the hardest one and most unrealistic one for people to actually sit down and have a real conversation with. As much as I hate to say that, like, I mean true brainwashed Republican, brainwashed Democrat, because both people, like, are just going to miss each other. The people that are, like, more centralists or centrists that either are more conservative, more liberal, those people can for sure have a conversation. But the ones that are, like, extremes on both sides, and I would say more so the liberal side, would have a much tougher time actually having a civilized conversation than the conservative side would. And I don't mean, like, alt-right, far-right, skinhead, that kind of person. But maybe not. Who knows? I think it's just good to see conversations happening between people that might agree or might disagree on one highly emotional issue, emotionally charged issue. So we'll see what happens. We'll see what happens there. I think it could be cool. Damn, 10 minutes in. What the hell have I been talking about for the last 10 minutes? I might be a teeny bit drunk right now. I only say that because I don't feel like I talked that long and it's just been 10 minutes, but okay. But yeah, this weekend's been good. It was fun. It's just funny how things can change so much and so quickly. And I mean this in a variety of different ways. The main thing I was thinking was, literally 2 weeks ago here in Finland, there was snow on the ground, or it snowed. And then today it was like 75. And this weekend it was 70, 75. And so just that quick change. And I was sitting at this pond, kind of lake, little mini lake on Sunday. And 2 weeks ago, it was frozen. And this week, there's people sitting around having beers, a girl playing guitar, which I'm going to get into. I went up and talked to her. In the pond, I know fish live under the ice during the winter, but there was so many fish in the lake. There's bugs on top of the lake. There's life, you know, and 2 weeks ago, it appeared there was no life. And so just that quick of a change. And even my opinion, in a way, on Finland overall kind of changed in the last 2 weeks. While I've been grateful to be here, given the circumstances, and especially regarding the lack of lockdowns and stuff like that, the winter here, I will admit, got long and kind of fucked with me in certain ways, mentally, with a combination of some other things also, and kind of gave me a first impression towards the place and the people in a specific direction. And the last two weekends with super nice weather have essentially changed the way I view Kuopio or Finland because of that. I mean, I went out and took a nice little walk on Saturday, was sitting there in the park on a bench, had my arms up, relaxing. And I mean, you would have thought that I was living in, like, Pleasantville. People riding their bikes past me, smiling. People sitting on the bench next to me, laughing, having good old time conversations, where 2 weeks, 3 weeks before, that place was like zombie land. Nobody would be there. Nobody hanging out. the only laughs and smiles you really heard out in public were drunken laughs in the bars. And now it's just, you couldn't walk 5 seconds without hearing a little laugh there and a little laugh there. Everywhere, here a laugh, there a laugh, everywhere a laugh, laugh. That's old McDonald, in case you didn't know. But yeah, it's a different place in general. And I realized also that I know that Finnish people got voted to being the happiest people, or Finland got voted to being the happiest country. And I will admit, being here from December until now, I thought that election was rigged. But now, after being here for 2 weeks in quote-unquote summer, I realized that the survey had to have taken place in June or July, or on a really sunny day in May, maybe. Because people are fucking excited right now. And it's refreshing, and I get it, and it's refreshing, and I love it. And I finally understand how those results came back the way they did. I used to think that it was because of being happy with the quality of life translated to happiness. But I get it now. It's a total different vibe out here overall. I'm already contemplating with van life. Okay, I go to Portugal, Spain for the winters. You know, maybe a little southern France. Or maybe, you know, some years go down to Greece. You know, the southern European spots for winter. Chase the sunshine. And then Nordics for the summer might be the move. Because if you can't tell by this pasty complexion and blonde hair, I don't do super well in the scorching heat. And I heard today in Lisbon, it was like 31 degrees, which I love Lisbon. I'm actually working on a little kind of documentary creative piece right now from a road trip from like 3 years ago. But I don't know if I can do, or I mean, I know I could do it. I don't know if I would truly enjoy, unless I was living by the beach and surfing and getting the water. It's possible. But it might be a nice switch up to come up to the old Finnish wilderness for the summer and get all that sunlight, baby. Just chasing the sun, like I said. And if you're going to chase the sun, Finland is the place to come. Yeah, definitely. Fuck, that's true. Although, on the note of the van life and things changing, boy, the crypto market sure has changed since last week when I recorded this podcast. And so now I've been thinking, okay, I could use this one coin to pretty much buy a van. And now I'm like, okay, I'm going to need to use all my crypto. But I don't know if it's because of Elon or what exactly, but fuck, dude. That shit crashed quick. And not crashed, it just dipped super hard. It'll recover. I'm now getting into the habit of watching some YouTube videos every morning on crypto so I can be a little more educated and know what the fuck I'm talking about. Because that's also, I don't know, if you have some time on your hands and that type of stuff interests you, crypto is a way to get rich with very little work. You got to do some work in terms of research and stuff like that and get a little lucky. But that's a formula for anything. So from everybody I listen to right now, and I'm no financial advisor, I don't know what the hell I'm really talking about, so don't even listen to me. But from the people who are smarter than me that I hear talking about it, most everybody says with Ethereum and Bitcoin, if you can keep that and hold it forever, basically, you'll do really well. And then with all the altcoins, those are the ones you need to research and kind of figure out when to buy, when to sell them, which ones to buy, and then the right timing of selling. Those aren't the ones you want to hold on for forever. Unless you're like me and you just forget about one that you believed in at the time that you bought it, and then it crashed, and then you're like, and then all of a sudden it's worth like 100x. No, not 100x. Like 40x. But now that's actually only worth like 20x with this crash, this dip that's happened. So yeah. What else? Oh yeah, this weekend, along with things have changed, like I alluded earlier, I went to the park on Sunday night, watched the sunset, which was absolutely beautiful. Posted a picture on my Instagram about it if you want to check that out, or a video on my TikTok. You know, got to plug everything right now. And I was sitting there eating some grapes, eating an orange, watching the sunset, having a nice little time, vibing out, reflecting. And maybe 100 yards away from me, or yeah, more or less, there was a girl sitting by the lake also on some rocks playing a guitar. And she was just far enough that I couldn't really hear her. And I love hearing some music, especially to a beautiful sunset. And so after a certain amount of time, I was kind of getting ready to leave, but at the same time, I was like, oh, I'll walk by her, and if she wants to talk back to me or whatever, I'll talk to her. And there was also this other guy who was sitting on a bench, maybe like in between us, who was riding his bike, and he was there for almost the whole sunset also. And so I walked past him and we kind of made eye contact. I said, hey, what's up, bro? Just in like a normal, you know, just a hello. And he kind of responded. I don't know how we got to talking, but we got to talking just for a little bit. And you know, he said he was from this area and this is like one of his favorite spots and blah, 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 blah. And it's just a good little vibe. And I'm back on the talk to strangers thing. I think we all just want to make a little connection here and there. And we really don't understand the impact that a small interaction can have on a stranger, both for them and for ourselves. And so for me, I'm trying to have those impacts, have those interactions, because fuck, dude, that's what this shit's all about, I think. I don't know. I don't know much, man. But I know I always feel better after like a nice little interaction. You know what I mean? So I kept walking past the dude, or, you know, I talked to him. I said, all right, man, I'm going to keep on going. And then I walked near her and she wasn't playing at the time that I walked by. I said, excuse me, are you going to keep playing? And she was like, oh, maybe. It's like, okay, well, I'll sit up here and listen to you then. She's like, well, you can come down and sit next to me or sit down by the rocks. I said, okay. So I went and sat down. We talked for a while, or talked for a long time. She played for a little bit. She was super good, super cool person. Ends up that she owns this workspace, co-working space, that I'd walked past multiple times and looked in the mirror and been like, yo, that place looks really fucking cool. I wonder what the story is for this place. I thought it was a cafe, but I've learned through her that legally you can't have a cafe because there's only one bathroom and can't be a pub because she doesn't have the liquor license yet and those kind of things. So she's kind of figured out a way to basically make money off the space as an event space and co-working space. And anyway, super cool spot. We end up going back there for a little bit, checking it out. She had these, like, I don't even know how to describe it, but it was this circuit board, I think. Again, I don't know what I'm talking about. With all these wires plugged into the circuit board that then had these clips onto these coins. And if you touched a coin, all of this was hooked up into her computer too. And if you touched a coin, it would make a sound out of the computer. And she had all these different noise or all these different sound packages. And so you could kind of make these like beats by touching these coins. And then you could clip two wires to one coin so it would make two sounds at once. And that shit was cool. That shit was a trip, boy. And it was super fun. And again, it just made me realize, like, we probably hung out that night for a couple hours. And I thought to myself, well, this all started because I asked, are you going to keep playing, maybe? And she said, yeah, I think so. And so that's how it starts. You know, and maybe, I mean, not maybe. I know that I'm looking for those kind of connections, like random connections that are more than just a hello, okay, goodbye. And so I find them because I'm looking for them. I think I'm not the only one who does that. I know I'm not the only one. I'm sure I'm not the only one. And so if those are the things that you want to do more in your life or whatever, I know I'm in no place to be giving advice really, but if you are truly like, try it out, man. It might not be the person you think it is, or it might not be the situation. Like a girl walked by with this really cute dog earlier and I thought, oh, maybe this is a like person I'm supposed to connect with tonight. I had a feeling I was going to connect with somebody that night. It wasn't her. And that's okay. The dog was still cute. Yeah, another guy was walking around the lake and he's like running for, there's municipal elections going on soon here in Finland. And so he handed out this little like card thing and just like kept walking. And I didn't say anything to him. And I was like, damn, maybe that was the guy I was supposed to talk to. And then ironically, I ended up seeing that guy today in the city center. And he was handing out the cards again and he recognized me. And I recognized him. And so I kind of asked for the spiel. And he gave it to me. And he seemed cool. He said, you know, I'm trying to get younger people to vote because only a third of the younger generation votes in the local elections, blah, blah, blah. I said, oh, that's cool, man. And we talked for a minute. And then I went, all right, man, well, good luck, and went to shake his hand. And he was like, oh, let's do the COVID elbow. And I fucking obliged. And now I'm mad at myself for doing it because I should have just, I mean, I guess I was being nice, but I should have just been like, I should have just grabbed his elbow. That's what I'm going to start doing from now on. If you go for the COVID elbow, I'm just grabbing that shit and shaking it. Fucking idiots. Oh. The fucking vote, the vid elbow shake. Fucking dummies. Especially here. Like here in Finland now, they've lifted all mask, not even mandates, but recommendations. You know, it's not even, you can if you want, they say, but it's not even recommended. Or, yeah, recommended is probably the right word. And so now to me, it's just real, real, real easy to spot the people who are utterly brainwashed. Because I get the recommendation, I get all those things, but given the vaccine and given the almighty government telling you that it's not even recommended anymore and you're still doing it, it's something else. I don't know. Do you? I got no problem with it, but like, it doesn't hurt me. It just makes me question. It makes me question someone's ability to think for themselves. Although I guess in a way they are thinking for themselves more, since it's not recommended. So maybe they really, really want to do it, so they are thinking for themselves. I don't know. It doesn't fucking matter. It's just a weird one, seeing people at the gym. And that's a weird thing with the fucking masks now, is I don't even know. It's the same way with the vaccines. Some people try and like portray it as, oh, well, I'm not wearing the mask to save me. I'm wearing it to save you. Right? That's the thing. I'm now getting the vaccine to, not to save myself, but to stop spreading it from someone else. Like, you know, just the ultimate virtue signaling bullshit. And so then when I see people that are still wearing it, the masks, despite it not being recommended, the way that my brain works, which could be wrong, it registers those people as they're wearing the masks for them. And there's been a lot of people that have been wearing the masks for them, which is okay. I'm not making fun of that at all. In the same way that a lot of the, almost all, I would say, of the people that are getting the vaccine are getting it for them. And so the point of all of this is that the people that try and parade around like, I'm wearing this and I'm getting this because I'm a great person and I'm trying to help and save other people, just becomes a pile of shit. Like, we all know it is. You know, the CDC now says, okay, well, if you're not vaccinated, you don't need to wear a mask. So that's going to, like, it kind of has eased things up a bit. But even there's people that have died now after, not from the vaccination, but have died from getting COVID and then dying after because of COVID after getting the vaccine. You know, there's still this like chance. I mean, it doesn't make any logical sense if you're thinking about it from a health perspective. And I have a feeling that they're just setting all of this up of saying, oh, well, you only need a mask if you're vaccinated in order to bring in that good old vaccine passport that we all know is coming. I need to get my Photoshop skills up and ready because it's eventually going to come, because there's going to be some drama that says, oh, so-and-so was lying about them not wearing a mask and them getting it. And so we need to make sure that people are telling the truth. That's for sure coming. We all know that. You know, we all know that. And on that same thing, good old Grandpa Joe came out with, I think it was a tweet, saying like, the rule get vaccinated or you will wear a mask until you do. It's like, And you're not, and people just think that's okay. And also people just think Trump was a dictator. Trump was the fascist. Trump was the, which listen, Trump was a fucking idiot. And Trump is continuing to prove that he's, I mean, I don't know if he's in the pockets of somebody now or what, but I mean, the way he's parading around with the vaccine, I mean, he's nobody to listen to either. But it's just ironic to me. The same people that flaunted him to be a fascist and a dictator and all these things have nothing to say when old Grandpa Joe says, the rule. Get vaccinated or you will wear a mask until you do. I don't know too much about politics. I don't know too much about dictatorships or anything like that. But to me, that sounds very dictatorial and very fascist, comparatively speaking, in the 21st century. But no, that's okay. Grandpa Joe can say that. He doesn't even know what he's saying, to be honest. Let's keep it real. No clue. I mean, none of these politicians. I saw there's this video of, here, we'll put the clip right now.
They're going to help us out. And did you say free fries when you get vaccinated? I got vaccinated. You're saying I could get this? These delicious fries. Wait a minute. But there's also a burger element to this. Let me check with Bill Neidhart. Is it too early in the day to eat a burger?
No.
This can be breakfast? Okay. I want you to look at this and think about, again, some people love hamburgers, some don't. Really want to respect all ways of life. But if this is appealing to you, just think of this when you think of vaccination. Vaccination. I'm getting a very good feeling about vaccination right this moment.
Yeah, that guy. If that video right there doesn't make you a little suspicious about what's going on, when they're having to bribe people, or I mean trying to bribe people with French fries and burgers and free beers and soon it'll be money. I've heard somewhere it was joints. Maybe joints is wrong, but it wouldn't shock me. When they're having to bribe people with these things to get something that supposedly is in your best health interest to save your life. Oh, donuts is another thing that they've tried to bribe people with. You know, you get free Krispy Kreme donuts. When they do all these things, when the number one reason for death by COVID is obesity, yet they're pushing French fries, donuts, and beer, it's pretty easy to know it's not about health, right? Is that, I mean, I'm asking, I know the answer. Is that controversial? It is, I understand that. But if you think logically and the government is offering, I won't use the word bribe, fries, donuts, and beer to prevent you from getting a virus, that the number one cause of death from that virus, comorbidity, was obesity. Logically, does that make any fucking sense that they would offer three things that make you more obese in the long run? like I said, if you think you think logically and that makes sense to you, maybe you're right. I don't know. Doesn't make any logic sense to me. To be fair, I haven't plugged in my TV and I haven't owned a TV in the last 2 or 3 years. So my logic is based a lot more on how I think rather than what the TV tells me to think. So I think that might play into a factor as well. But this whole thing is just like incredibly hypocritical. And by this whole thing, I mean the Biden administration. And again, maybe we're better off. I'm not saying Trump was a better option, to be honest, at this point. Now, seeing what I've seen. But Biden's back building the wall. The whole children in cages thing was happening at the border, even worse. And he just gets a complete pass from the media. And again, it's just so fucked up because by me saying this, now I get perceived as a pro-Trump diehard. And I think Trump is fucking stupid. I think they're all stupid. I think if you think one of them is great, you're stupid. And again, even though I think you're stupid, it doesn't mean I hate you. It doesn't mean that I don't think we could get along and probably talk and laugh and have a great time talking about a lot of other subjects. I just want to bring up the fact that the media only has one narrative, a one-way street narrative. And I don't have the answer. Although I say if there's ever going to be a revolution in the world, but especially the US, which is where it probably needs to start first regarding all the insanity that's going on, the revolution has to start at media companies, mainstream media. That is what has to be essentially taken down or infiltrated first. Because the media is the most powerful thing on the planet right now. The grip that it has on people's minds is insane. And even here in Finland, people think because their media regarding the government is unbiased because it's not paid for, or it's independently paid for. I'm not exactly sure the right word to use. I've just heard from my Finnish friends that some feel that it's unbiased because it comes from a neutral organization. Maybe I'm wrong. And so maybe, I don't know. I don't fuck with Finnish politics because I'm not Finnish. And yes, I live here, but I don't think my say matters, to be honest. And I don't plan on living here for a long time. So there's multiple reasons. But the thing that people here don't realize is because they think that their news media about their country is unbiased, they think that whatever they get regarding the U.S. is also unbiased. And I try to tell them that no matter what you get from the U.S., that media is incredibly biased and agenda-based. It doesn't matter who it's from, whether it's from a CNN or a Fox News or everything in between, there's an agenda to it. And so what will bug me here is when a Finnish person who's never been to the US will try and come off like they really understand and really know what's going on in US politics because they've watched their TV that they think is unbiased and it's told them this one thing. And it's like, yeah, maybe that one thing is true, but that's not the full story. Because ultimately that news database is getting it from a US news database, which is biased. If there was, it's not like there's a Finnish person sitting in every White House news conference, sitting there asking questions. There shouldn't be. I'm not saying there should be. But that would be the only like true way to make it unbiased, is if someone was actually there. And that's just not the case in a majority of the situations. And so, yeah, that's one thing that'll bug me out here sometimes. I guess we can close out on just some stupid shit, I guess. And by stupid shit, I mean little random cultural things that I notice. And to start, because this is mainly to do with the internet, I've realized how creepy the internet really is. Because this last week at some point on TikTok, a girl was doing a live of just her sleeping. And there were like 200 people watching it. And it's not like she was in sexy underwear or anything like that. Just sleeping. It's like there's 200 people in this little live room watching a girl sleep. And that is fucking creepy as hell. Obviously, I was there for 10 seconds or what, like, to realize this girl is just sleeping. And so maybe there were others that were doing the same thing. But I get a maximum of 25 or 30 people in my lives. Yeah. I don't know. That one creeped me out. That one made me like scared a little bit. And just the whole staying on TikTok stuff and just social media in general, I sound so old as I say this, I realize. But the music nowadays, back in my day, but the music that's constantly promoted on TikTok and social media and just the mainstream stuff, whether it be Nicki Minaj, fucking WAP, whatever it is just ultimately promoting disrespect and a lack of care, a lack of relationships, a lack of human decency. And my couple little examples, maybe I'll play little TikTok clips like right here, but there's a Toxic song about like, I'm toxic, or she's toxic, they're toxic, but really I'm toxic. I'll just play the clip. I read until I'm dead, I know that he watching. Left my ex bitch cause she toxic. Damn. Got this new bitch, now we toxic, can't cap, I be toxic. Damn. And then there's another one that's like, basically a girl singing like, I feel like fucking, dun 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 corny, It's like, just knowing that like 12 to 16 year olds are ingesting this and getting that stuck in their head, essentially programming themselves, is a little scary. And I'm sure there was some shit when I was growing up that was very, very similar. I've been over, girl. Show me what you're working with. Shake your ass. Watch yourself. Shake your ass. Show me what you're working with. But I don't know. What was the Nelly Kelly Rowland song? I mean, there was some like good music when I was that age. Let me see. Hold on. Let's look up this Nelly. That shit was sweet. I mean, I guess it might have been about someone cheating on someone else, now that I think about it. If I think about the music video. Dilemma. Oh, yeah. And I love you. And I need you. Nelly, I love you. I do. No matter what I do, all I think about is you. Even when I'm with my boo, you know that I'm a crazy over you. Damn, I have to be drunk. Maybe I'm turning Finnish. I'm doing some fucking karaoke right now. Jesus Christ. But yeah, that was a song. Okay, maybe even when I'm with my boo, all I can think about is you. Okay, not the best message, I'll admit. But a better and a cuter message and a much more sweet message than I feel like fucking something. You know? And even there's all these like weird little trends or something, or I don't get this one at all as a guy. Sorry, mom, to hear this. Although I'm good when I'm saying this. There's like this trend thing in social media and culture, relationship culture, hookup culture, that girls want to be spit in their face, like while you're doing stuff with them. And I don't know. I have no desire to do that at this point in my life. Maybe I'll change in 5 years. I don't know. But that one just seems so weird and like incredibly disrespectful. And I'm not trying to come off as like some simp, goody two shoes, good boy, because I'm definitely not. But that one, again, just thinking the impact of a 12 to 16-year-old, both boy and girl, watching and thinking, like, that's cool, that's what it is. I don't know. I just think in the long run, it's not the best thing. If when I was coming up, even when I'm with my boo, was bad, and knowing how myself and some of my friends turned out, which for the most part is actually pretty good, but some of us, it just makes me think, well, okay, what if instead of thinking about you when I'm with my boo, we were thinking, spit in my face and I want to fuck something or someone. Those are slightly different messages, if you ask me. No? Okay. I don't know. On this note, though, I think all guys need to hear this, that if a girl follows you on Instagram, she is shooting her shot. So, fellas, you need to act accordingly with that follow, or even like two likes on a picture, even one like on a picture, that's a girl shooting her shot nowadays online. So say what's up. I'm speaking from a teeny bit of experience right here, where in the past that would maybe happen and I'd maybe play the like for like game back and forth. Now, if there's a follow and a couple likes, and I seem interested, I'm saying what's up. They always respond. Granted, they always live 5 hours to 20 hours away, but they always respond. So fellas, if that happens and you're like, oh, I can't, I don't know how to talk to you, shut the fuck up, shoot your shot, because they just shot their shot. And my last thing we will end on is I've realized that this week I've done a little bit of research with this. Finnish people will cut their fingernails not with nail clippers. A majority of them here use the little scissors to cut their fingernails. And all I have to say about that is if you use scissors to cut your fingernails, you are a fucking child. And that's how it is. Adults use clippers. I used the scissors when I was like 10 years old. Yes, it's like safer or something, or like you don't cut too far down as easily. It takes 3 times the amount of time. And also become an adult and use clippers. I've now surveyed a lot of my Finnish friends, and an overwhelming majority use scissors. I don't know where, how this started, why, but you're a child and use fingernail clippers. Alrighty. I'm going to finish under an hour. Last two episodes have almost been identical timestamps. They were like an hour, 4 minutes, and 30 seconds or something. Within like 10 seconds of each other. This one will not follow suit. We're getting under an hour on this one. Oh, my first little sample of merch came in today. So I'll be wearing that next week on the show. And should have that available whenever. So if you're interested in that kind of stuff, again, I save all this stuff for the very, very end for those people that are super duper supportive, which I really, really appreciate. If you're curious or you like would like to support and get some merch in some way, shape, or form earlier than everybody else, just message me and I can make it happen. I'll figure it out. It's not like this big moneymaker thing kind of thing for me. I'm just more so doing it obviously to make a little bit of money, but also free advertising, all those kind of things. So if that interests you and you want to see a couple of the ideas that I got with the website that I'm doing it on, I can order one print. I think t-shirts will be about $25. Let me know. I'll send you the message, send you a couple ideas. I'd like to hear some feedback too, so that'd be cool for multiple reasons. And we'll make it happen. Alrighty? Cool. Alrighty, y'all. Appreciate you. Peace and much love. Holla. Living for a living, baby. How you doing?